How can ice on compressor confuse during low ref unit? Please explain how much ice is allowed on compressor. Yeah, that's a very good question. I am actually going to be doing some webinars on, let's say, system design, compressor failures, commissioning, all of that. Now, let's do our lovely diagram again. Let's do it this way around. Machine, now piston, ding, 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 expansion valve, our evaporator. So that's discharge, suction, condenser, evap. Nice simple system. I hope you can see that. Yeah, you can see that. Good. So let's say we are evaporating, I don't know, let's say minus five. Now, so we're evaporating minus five. Now, with our expansion valve bulb, let's come around here. There's our bulb on our suction line. So we're measuring the superheat on our evaporator. Now, if our suction pressure that we're reading there is, sorry, suction temperature is minus five, depending on the refrigerant that we're using. Now, if we've got, let's say, if we're evaporating minus five there, and we've got, I don't know, let's say plus three there. So we've got 7 degrees of superheat. And a superheated, what's superheated vapor? Steam is a superheated vapor because it is above its boiling point. So water boils at 100 degrees C. If you measure steam, it's more than 100 degrees C, so it's superheated. So hope that sort of explains it, because we feed our liquid in to our evaporator through the expanded liquid, and we pass air over that evaporator. The refrigerant that's boiling off in our evaporator is absorbing our heat. So think of that like the kettle. So out of our evaporator, we don't want minus five, because if we had minus five, we'd have a liquid vapor mix, which we don't want. So we've got plus three. We've got 7K superheat there. And then back at our machine, and I'm just going to remove that because I don't want to, let's say, confuse. So we've got plus three there. Now, if we had plus three there as well, measured with a probe on our suction stub of our machine, we'd only have 7K superheat. The challenge is you won't get that unless that distance is incredibly short. On a typical installation, if you've got 3 meters of pipe, 10 meters of pipe, 70 meters of pipe, all them sort of strange things that we see, you will always pick up some superheat in that suction line, even though it should be insulated. We'll still pick up some heat. So we might be, can't read that. Plus 10. So then we've got, let's work that out. We've got 7K suction superheat. So we're picking up a little bit of heat in here, and we're going to make sure that coming back to the machine, it's vapor. What we don't want liquid coming back to our machine, because as I've said before, compressor is a vapor pump, it's not a liquid pump. The challenge is, let's just change some of our figures a minute. Let's say we now, let's make it nice and cold. We're going to evaporate, let's say, minus 30 C. And apologies for everybody who works in F. Let me check. Yeah, so we're evaporating at minus 30. Now, if we keep our superheat, let's say, I don't know, let's change it around a little bit. Let's say we've got 5K superheat, which is not a lot, but just to keep the maths nice and simple. So here we'll have minus 25. Now, the problem is, what you don't want to do is you don't want to have, let's say, plus 20 here, because then you've got 45k of suction superheat. And our compressor won't cope with that because that compressor is designed as a low temperature compressor. Now, you might pick up, so we're at minus 30, minus 25. We might pick up, let's say 10K or let's say 15K superheat. So that means here we're minus 10. So if we're minus 10 there and it's a nice, moist ambient temperature, we're going to have frost on our suction stub. Doesn't necessarily mean we've got liquid, just means that it's cold. But you only know if it's cold and not liquid by actually measuring your superheat in your evaporator and your suction superheat, or your total superheat, which is that. So that's the way to check if your machine or your system is behaving itself.